morning. Welcome to Bell Laboratories. This is one of the places where we research and develop communication systems of the future. You know, it all began with a simple pair of wires over which two people could talk to each other. But as the nation grew, phone communication had to grow right along with it.
I sure hope these plans for my telephone work. It should be pretty easy.
I wonder what they're doing today. Think I'll go take a look.
Let's see. I'll need string and cups and what else?
Maybe this time they'll let me play with them. There they are.
I bet we could talk to the astronauts if we could get enough string. Boy, we could make a fortune. I better make these plans top secret.
Transmission systems range from a pair of wires that carry one conversation to this coaxial cable that carries up to 90,000 conversations at the same time. The coaxial cable can carry broadcast television and computer data as well, and also a picture phone.
Shh! Don't let my mother see us. Cups. And string. Okay, let's get out of here.
Cable is only one of our transmission methods. Another, of course, is radio relay.
Most of the long-distance transmission needs of the 50s and 60s were served by microwave radio systems through towers such as this TD-2. This, of course, is a scale model. These systems have steadily improved to where today they carry 36,000 telephone messages.
They'll be sorry they wouldn't let me help.
In the future, we plan to use very high-frequency radio waves to carry almost a quarter of a million telephone conversations or over 2,400 picture phone channels across the country. If you take a close look at the waveguide, you will see that it is basically a steel tube in which there has been placed a copper conducting lining, and then inside of that there is a plastic dielectric lining.
There's got to be an easier way to do this.
Boys are so clumsy.
And now we're working with some new possibilities. Laser light, carried through glass fibers.
Don't let the string go slack.
Aw, rats.
These scientists are conducting an experiment using laser light to transmit voice over optical fibers. Of course, we still have to solve many problems.
Now it's my turn.
What are the best materials to use?
This is simple.
What new equipment will be needed?
That should do it.
What effect will distance have on transmission?
Great.
What's she doing with my telephone?
All right, how is this?
Yeah, let's try it.
Hey, she fixed it.
Hello? Can you hear me?
Not so good. Speak right into the center of the cup.
I'm going to adjust the tracking control pod here. All right, here we go, all the way.
That's a little too far. Cut it back just a bit.
All right. How about the bias?
Put your hair away from your ear, silly.
That was better.
How is that?
That's better. A little bit more.
Is it okay now?
Yeah, it really works. I'm going to start our own phone company.
Good. I want to be president.
Right about there. That's fine.
Very good.
Very good. It's working now.
That's swell.
That's good.
You know, a coast-to-coast call today cost a small fraction of what it did in 1936. And that's really the point of all this research and experimentation, to reduce costs and to improve our communications capabilities. Now, if we just learn to listen to each other.